in School of Nursing, students need to go to clinical practicum. Due to high patient acuity, some wards may be very busy. Students may find disparities in their learning experience. And especially in COVID-19, where students can't get into clinical, we really need to do something about that in order to enhance their clinical competence. We usually engage students by creating a sim ward. Basically, students will come as a group, like 4 to 5 per ward. We'll have 4 beds, so each student will care for 1 patient. You can see tables are similar, the cupboards are similar, so it's really mimicking what's it like in a public hospital. Here's one of our high fidelity mannequins, namely Athena. She's very, very smart. You see here, like I'm getting her bed up right now. You can see that she is able to respond to light. Even her eyes are able to bleed, change color, and the pupil size will constrict. This is the control room. There are 4 computers with a recording system here. There are cameras outside that can record every single detail of the students. And most importantly, in simulation, we can show that video again to debrief the student. We've set up a normal case with different vital signs, like heart rate, respiratory rate, BP, SpO2, and the mean arterial pressure. We can always change different variables of the patient, no matter from the cardiovascular function, lung function, or even the neurological function. So changing the different sizes of the eyes is possible here, and it could really facilitate the students' modalities in learning.
Good afternoon, I am now. I am the robot client for the year 1 students to assist them to understand how to take health history.
He's telling me that he can help students to take health history. At times we can program now to talk, like to pretend to be a real patient, and now can actually answer questions towards the student's response. So come on now, can you walk in front of me? You see he's performing, I guess it's Chinese Kung Fu, like Tai Chi. Why we want to have now to have this kind of function is that our nursing students often go to clinical placements outside in the community. So students can take now outside to the community, engage the community by like teaching elderly people, people in rehabilitation to do exercises. So now would actually be the instructor in that process. Even though the fidelity is mimicked to a higher level, the immersion at times could not be as great as VR. Say for example, we've had actually a lot of scenarios working with IMSI in Hong Kong U to develop different scenarios in virtual reality. Come over here, we can see she's preparing the equipment for the nasogastric insertion of a pediatric patient, which normally you can't really see these cases in the clinical setting. Next, what she needs to do is to actually insert the nasogastric tube for the baby. She needs to actually prepare all the documents, check everything. Everything can be practiced within that virtual reality setting. When she inserts the nasogastric tube, what's special is that we can provide instantaneous feedback for the students. We're working with a developer with industrial engineering in a UGC project to see whether we can have a possibility to generate a new virtual reality platform where other faculties from the universities are able to generate their own scenarios. It's all about increasing the fidelity of the simulation, because often students, they always complain, well, it's not realistic. So after the development of the simulation center, students get to appreciate the realism of the simulation and becoming a ward. There's a great disparity in learning opportunities. So this great disparity can be solved by recreating this immersive environment so that every single student in Hong Kong UMed will be able to participate in the same amount of activities. They get the same amount of training before they meet their patients. And that's what we really want to do.